Insidious, the last key review. Hey, what's up guys, it's Josh here. Today I want to do a little review on a movie called Insidious, the last key. Now I think this came out in 2018. I don't know if you guys saw my initial Insidious review, but to me, I consider Insidious one of the best horror movies of all time. In my opinion, it was near perfect. I had seen Insidious, I had seen Insidious 2. I'm pretty sure I saw Insidious 3, but I think Insidious 3 was where I was really just not really engaged with it. I was kind of just falling out from it. I'd have to go back to see if I liked it, but I did think number 2 was very solid, and I had never seen Last Key. So when I was looking back through all these, I was actually pretty excited to check it out. This movie is about the paranormal investigator Elise from the very first movie. Although I really liked everybody's performances, I did think Elise was the best, so it is nice to see her here. This movie takes place in 2010, directly before the original Insidious, so it basically leads directly into the Insidious. It kind of goes over Elise's backstory, you know, growing up, some trouble she had in her house. She gets a call from somebody who's having a haunting, and it ends up that that person is in her old house. So she's basically going back to this house that caused her a lot of trauma to kind of help this guy who's having a problem with a new ghost going on in the house. That's kind of the basic synopsis of this movie. The pros is the monster slash monsters. The very first Insidious, I really enjoyed the buildup that they had for the evil characters, the bad characters. I thought that they was kind of outside the box, scary, and I just really enjoyed the whole mystique that they put around the main monsters in Insidious, and this movie is no different. The main monster is very unique. He actually is really kind of scary. I just really appreciate what they did with this character. To me, it feels fresh and scary and all the things I wanted in a creepy monster. This monster pretty much has it, so I really enjoy it. I really did enjoy the mystery aspect of it. When you have the original Insidious, you know something's going on, but you really don't know exactly how it's gonna end, and it has this kind of mysterious vibe to it, to where you want to see what is going to happen at the end, what's the punchline, because everything's so bizarre. And in this movie, you kind of have that too. You know something's weird's happening, it's going to have a crazy conclusion, you know all this, but you don't really know exactly how it's going to go. It really feels like a mystery until things get unveiled, which I actually really, really appreciated. And then also the last pro is that it has echoes of the original Insidious. The whole vibes to it, how serious it was, the kind of quirky little high-pitched music that's just so Insidious, and the kind of bone-chilling scenes. It does slightly come through in this movie. I would say about a third of the time I was engulfed in that Insidious style feel. Some mixed aspects. In the beginning of the movie, it's basically Elise growing up, and Elise's dad is very, very abusive. Every time Elise claims to see a monster or see something, he beats her. I really don't like it. To be honest, this would have been a hard in the cons, but there is kind of like a twist or something that you don't expect later on that kind of explains more to what's going on, to where it doesn't seem as tasteless and just hard to watch as it was in the beginning. Because to be honest, I was really turned off by this, did not want to see this. I thought it was just 100% the wrong way. But later on, it kind of has a slight meaning to it, so it kind of gets better. Also, the person calling Elise, this person who lives in Elise's old house, this guy, I just really didn't like him. He's just kind of weird and creepy. They have another twist kind of in store with that whole thing. It doesn't end on this really flat, terrible note. It's almost like maybe he was acting a specific way because of this twist coming out later. I'm not too sure. So it's kind of mixed on those two characters. Okay, let's get into the cons of this movie. The cons is that it is overall much less engaging than the first Insidious. I would say with Insidious and The Conjuring, most of the movie, I'm completely engaged 100% of the time. There's not a point where I'm taken out of it. I was probably taken out of the movie maybe about 10 times during it. Also, they have some really good jump scares, but they do have some repeat scares in this movie, scares that was done in the very first Insidious. And I feel like they don't do enough to earn your respect as far as these scares. When you watch Insidious and you watch The Conjuring, there's not that many scares in those movies. It's mostly just really, really suspenseful, and then they toss in a scare. Really, really suspenseful, and they toss in a scare. With this movie, you just felt like they were gonna try to give you almost too many jump scares to the point where you don't really trust the movie. You almost just wanna look away. It almost feels a little bit cheap versus Insidious and The Conjuring. Everything felt so organic. It did not feel like a cheap jump scare. It's hard to explain. The cringy paranormal guy scenes, oh my goodness. So obviously these paranormal guys aren't like the coolest guys in the world. They kind of act like they're cool, but obviously they have a little bit of a geeky side to them. But oh my goodness, probably about 5 times at least, they just have to have an entire scene about them looking just so stupid in front of these girls. I mean, it was at least 5 scenes. They had some new characters in this movie. The new girls are just kind of lifeless. They weren't really memorable in any way. If I were to rate this movie, I'd probably give it about a 6.5 to a 7. I would say it's an average run-of-the-mill horror movie. Own it, rent, or pass. I would say this is a rent. This is far from a perfect movie. This has a lot of scenes that are kind of like, eh. But it does have a few redeeming qualities to where if you got nothing else to watch, you want to see what they're up to. It also has James Wan and Lee Whannell have their finger in this, which I love both those guys. I could almost feel the James Wan style vibe in here just because of some of the scenes hit very good. But if you liked Insidious and you like paranormal movies, more on a rent. And if you don't like them, then I would go on a pass. Have you seen Insidious, The Last Key? What's some other horror movies that you want me to see? What's your favorite paranormal horror movie? I'd be very interested to see down below. We're on the road to 50,000 subscribers and I could not do it without any of you guys' help. You guys are the best. I'm having a great day out here. Hopefully you're having a great day at home. See you all in the next video. Peace.